Jay Haynes with the Film Sensei YouTube channel. Today in this quick tip video, I'm going to show how to do this fade blur transition in HitFilm Express. So the fade blur transition is a super popular transition that does not actually come standard in HitFilm. However, it is very easy to accomplish. I have placed both of my clips here on the editor timeline, and I'm going to open up transitions video under the dissolve folder and find the cross dissolve transition. Now, I don't know about you, but I like this transition to be pretty quick, so I'm only going to come back 5 frames and it'll only travel across 10 frames on a 30 frames per second video clip. Now, what I need to do is look under blurs and find a regular blur, which, by the way, is called a Gaussian blur in many different video editing softwares, but in HitFilm is just called a blur. I'm going to drag this blur effect onto the first clip, and I will set this to about 50 or so at the point where it is changing, and then I will keyframe the radius. I can back up and then draw it down to 0. Then I will drag that same blur effect onto the second clip. And again, at the very beginning of that clip, I will set that to 50. Turning on keyframing, I can go to the end of the transition and it becomes 0. And so now you have something that looks like that. Now, having said that, I prefer to actually take the blurring effect a little bit further down, clicking on this display timeline icon. I can go ahead and zoom in here to see my keyframes, and I like to actually extend the blur past the transition point, and then I would do the same thing here on the previous clip, again just dragging that back a little bit so that the blur begins before the transition happens this way. So that's sort of a personal choice, whatever you feel is best for your personal project. I'm Jay Haynes for the Film Sensei YouTube channel, and that is how you do a fade blur transition in HitFilm Express. Do me a favor and like this video, and feel free to subscribe to the channel, click the little bell icon for notifications, and as always, thanks for watching.